nine. Coke on the side. The brother loved the highlight. Had a PhD in street stride. They called him the Jackal.
I was going to sing Somewhere Beyond the Sea, but it's Across the Sea. Somewhere across the sea. That's the name of the episode.
Oh, you never told me that.
No.
Now I'm getting it.
Hello, welcome to LOSTies with Jed and Cara. My name is Jed.
And I'm Cara.
And we are a video podcast talking about Lost. Oh wait, this is like our 67th episode. So,
I think there's anyone tuning in for the first time.
Hopefully not. Sixth season, 15th episode, episode 615. It's called What?
Somewhere Beyond the Sea?
No, it's Across the Sea. Oh, Damon and Carlton wrote it.
Ooh.
So it's the big guns, obviously. And Tucker Gates directed it. He's directed quite a few episodes. And wow, this is just one giant shot glass of mythology, man.
Yes, it is.
This was just one giant chunk of the story of Jacob and that guy who remains nameless
forever. The
other
guy, we don't know.
And crazy mother.
Two crazy mothers.
Two crazy mothers.
Not really.
One was just a nice mother who got brained by the crazy mother.
Yeah. She did come back from the dead.
Claudia. Her name was Claudia.
Yeah.
Sure,
Claudia.
There's some literature, she's something in literature probably.
Someone will have to share that information with us.
Claudia. And we couldn't tell what language they were speaking at the beginning.
No.
But I did like the when they play that little music and they change to English.
Mihi nomen es Claudia. That's a lovely name.
Yeah.
Yeah, it reminded me of the movie The Hunt for Red October.
That means they're always speaking the other language.
Right.
They just don't have to do the subtitles.
So they spoke that other language the whole time, and I don't know what it was. But have you seen The Hunt for Red October?
No.
Why haven't you seen the coolest movies ever made? The Hunt for Red October. Okay.
Because I do other
while
fun
I'm editing
stuff.
This, you should just go watch it, okay? Because frankly, I bet you everyone who watches this podcast is just shaking their head like, seriously, have you not seen Sean Connery, Alec Baldwin in the real dark hair, non-dye phase? I did like at the beginning, it was strange. Well, first, Claudia was in a red dress, which was really interesting. Mm-hmm. And she had blood pouring out of her. But then also when they went to the, well, actually, where she found her, there was red roses everywhere, red flowers.
Oh, I didn't notice that.
And I guess Lost has never really used red on the show that much, other than, you know, the term red shirts. People who wear red shirts get killed, and there's red clothing worn, but not the way it was used in this episode. It just really stood out. The color red stood out quite a bit. And it was in that lighted tunnel area place. There was all sorts of red roses and red flowers around. It was like the embodiment of Eden or something. I'm not sure what the red was meaning, but it...
I'm sure it meant something.
It was
I'm
just
sure I've missed a lot of things. About
no, it was just a thematic idea. They used the color red. Every question leads to another question.
How long have
every
you...
question I answer will simply lead to another question.
So every question leads to another question. I mean, yep. That's just totally like... That is totally the producers talking to the fans.
Saying, don't ask us any more questions.
Every question you ask leads to another... Or that's just the idea of the show. is every question that we come up with leads to another question of why. So no matter what, you're going to be left with questions. That's what this is all about.
Yes, I was still left with questions.
Yeah, big time. Jacob, man in black. Or baby in black.
Right.
At the start.
Jacob and the other one that we don't ever call by name.
K-I-B. Kid in black. Kid in black. Baby in black. Bib, Kib, and Mib. They kind of arrived on this island just like everybody else, just like the Losties. And then this sort of godlike creature, Mother, just claimed them.
Yeah.
Claimed them as her own and made them into something special.
I guess.
What'd you make of that?
It was a little crazy. I felt bad for Claudia. She just did all this work and then she gets killed. Yeah.
And that birthing scene. She's pregnant, so it's weird for us. But hopefully no one clubs Cara with a rock.
Yeah.
That is horrible.
Yeah. It was horrible.
Sorry about this.
I was like, what?
I'm sorry.
That's too bad.
Well, you kind of knew when she wouldn't show her the babies.
I'm gonna
Doesn't
name
even
him,
get to see them.
I'm gonna name him Jacob. Oh crap. I didn't come up with another name.
I don't have another name.
Oopsie. We'll just kind of act like that one didn't happen.
You're special.
Man in black is special. KIB. Kid in black is special. What's so special about him? He decides to not follow her.
He thinks on his own.
He's going to live forever. He's like a demigod, but he fights against it. And I don't know. This is craziness. So they go to the lighted, Eden, happy Disney World
tunnel.
Place. Let's just call it Disney World. The tunnel of Disney. Light. Tinkerbell's cave. Cave of Tinkerbell. Tink cave. Tink, okay. Cave Tink.
And if the light goes out here, it goes out everywhere. And so I've protected this place, but I can't protect it forever.
Which, at the end, it seemed like when the smoke monster was born from the light,
that it went dark.
Out.
Yeah. So I don't know what that means, but...
Yeah. What if that has something to do with the Sideways world? Light goes out here, it goes out everywhere.
Or maybe there's just a little bit of light left. You just couldn't see it.
I don't know. This episode's giving me a headache. And then we get scene number one of Jacob punching the piss out of poor K.I.B.
No!
Just smacking that kid up. Yeah.
Well, he just called his mom a liar.
Yeah.
So the kid Jacob, though, is that the kid that... Locke keeps seeing.
It looked like him.
That's what I thought too.
Looked like the same kid, but I can, who freaking knows? I'm going to say that it's supposed to be the same kid. I don't know. Episode 67, folks. And we are just as confused as when we freaking started. So Jacob is quite the mama's boy.
Will you stay with me, Jacob? Please.
Yes, you did mention that during the episode, but I think if your mother is the only one you're with all of your life, then it would be tough to not be a mama's boy.
Mom, let me get this straight. So I had a mom, and then you bludgeoned her to death with a rock. But now you're my mom. Yes. I'm good with that.
He didn't see his mother.
That's true. Only Kid in Black had the ability to see the other mother.
So
that's why he's special. Because he got to see the dead people.
Yes.
Okay. Kid in Black is pissed. He leaves and goes and joins the humans, who I could not tell what kind of clan they were supposed to be.
No.
And it was probably supposed to be nondescript so that we go crazy and look it up. But maybe, you know, like the guy was wearing sort of this belt buckle thing that you might be able to, people might dissect that and figure out who they're trying to point to as the people that arrived on the island. I don't know. I don't know what time period this is supposed to be. Mom is something like a demigod, or she's a god maybe, and she's kind of given them the godlike power. So when he runs off from his mom and his brother Jacob, he's like a demigod amongst the people, and he realizes how scummy they are. So that's why he has this hatred for mankind, and he repeats the line from the incident. She says that about all the people.
Why didn't you tell us about them?
Because they're dangerous and I didn't want to frighten you.
What makes them dangerous?
The same thing that makes all men dangerous. They come, fight, they destroy, they corrupt, and it always ends the same.
So Man in Black is going to leave. Mom's not too thrilled.
No.
Mom's going to go try to cuddle her son to death. Well, okay, the donkey wheel.
Yes.
I'm not sure the physics of anything they're talking about makes sense.
We're going to make an opening. One much bigger than this one. And then I'm going to attach that wheel to a system we're building. A system that channels the water and the light. And then I'm going to turn it. And when I do, I'll finally be able to leave this place.
He's going to put a big hole there, put the donkey wheel in, and somehow the water, they figured out the water and the light are going to be able to move the island, whatever. But apparently, she filled in that hole, and that didn't get done.
Right.
I don't get it.
But first she said, I'm sorry, before she shoved him into the...
More mom violence.
So, mom, if mom says you're sorry, she's sorry.
If a mom apologizes, run like hell.
I am so sorry.
Yes. You come home saying you're sorry, I better watch my back.
Exactly.
And this was very Mother's Day. They timed it well.
It was very much.
So then mom takes Jacob to the light, to Cave Tink, and they have a drink.
Yes.
This is all weird. Having drinks with mom.
You now have the power. You have to protect.
It's like He-Man. Amen. Yes, Jacob has been bestowed the power of Grayskull.
I don't care.
So then mom's time is done.
Right. So basically she was the protector of the heart.
Of the light.
Protector of the light. Protector of the light. Protector of the light. Which means what? So she died the same way Jacob died with that knife. Or being stabbed.
Right.
I guess it wasn't that knife in particular, but being stabbed the same way Jacob died. Scene number two of Jacob beating the piss out of Man in Black. Man in Black is thrown into the light, and
yes.
It's kind of creepy. I got sucked under that water.
Yeah, it was.
Strange. And then what happened?
Smoke monster comes out.
Okay.
So now we know where the smoke monster comes from.
Yes. No, we don't.
What?
The body went under the water and came out the other side. When Jacob goes over this hill, I think he's finding Man in Black's body on the other side, and smoke monster's just roaming. He's just a smoke monster now, and there's his body. I think that's how that worked. It didn't quite make sense to me. Cara said, like, well, his body popped out of smoke monster. I don't think it's it.
I thought that his body flew with the smoke monster, and he just dropped it. They're Adam and Eve.
Yes.
Oh, yes. Adam and Eve. And who do you think Adam and Eve was? Let's go back to that.
Yeah. Yeah, well. So it's Man in Black and his mom. And they're his both mom. Nameless. They could be Adam and they could be Eve, all we know.
That's true. What? Are you unhappy?
Well, I mean, we've always been told that Adam and Eve was going to demonstrate that they've had this thing planned from the beginning. So the simple fact that it's Man in Black and his mom that associates with Jacob. I guess that means that they've had this Jacob thing planned from the very beginning, that it was some sort of demigod and the brothers and...
Don't tell my heart, my achy, breaking heart. I just
don't know. Delivery doesn't feel that fresh and good.
You weren't entertained?
No. I don't really get anything out of the story. But it went nowhere from there. I don't mean that I really give a crap about his name, because they don't want to be implicit.
I thought it was good. Don't tell my heart, my achy, breaky heart.
I just don't think he'd understand. Okay.
What are you gonna grade this?
Oh.
I can't wait to hear.
I don't know. Did you like CJ Craig?
I did. I think she did a good job. And she looked pretty natural.
You mean like no makeup?
Like no makeup.
That's mean.
That's free. No, that's good though.
You're pointing out that she had no makeup on. I'm going to give it a B.
B.
A B.
I'm giving it an A.
A big A. Yes. I can't. You know why I'm pissed off right now is because I know how many beautiful messages I'm going to get of people mad at us because I didn't like the episode that much.
Well, I liked it. We found out a lot of information, answered our questions, and I think that's good. That's what we want. Some people don't like the answers.
I'm enjoying this. Continue. I'm not sure really what the value of this was, watching this episode. What it did, I mean, we saw where the smoke monster came from. A big white light cave. It tells us nothing.
What did you want it to be?
I don't know, but why go into this story if that's going to be the answer? It's not an answer, it's just insano.
Well, that's it. Till the weekend, we'll be in a better mood and happier. And we can't wait to get all your vid mails, so send them in and tell us how good the episode was so that...
Cheer up old Jed.
Yes, Jed will cheer up.
Well, hopefully everyone did really enjoy the episode. Hopefully, because this is what they've had in their minds all the time. So hopefully everyone does really enjoy what they did. I'm just being a negative ninny, guys. Don't go the path of Jed. And make your finale plans, folks. We're excited. Matt, we've got the hotel for St. Louis and got some Lost party kits ordered and we're working on the details. So it should be lots of fun and I'm excited to see if anyone actually shows up. People who watch our podcast and listening to Keys, it'll be just interesting to meet some of these people.
Hopefully. Yeah.
So what we got out of it? Slap it!
Just watch it again.